And in this video, we're gonna be tearing apart this go-kart even further. We gotta get this axle out of here, and that axle's gotta get to a machine shop. So first things first, I gotta get this belt loosened up. So there's a tensioner pulley that'll loosen that thing up. And then I gotta get this brake caliper out of here, and that whole brake caliper's gotta come out so it doesn't interfere with the rotor as I'm pulling that axle up. Pretty simple, you just got 6 bolts holding these bearings on. Once we get those 6 bolts free, this axle should come right out. So you're probably wondering why this axle has to go to the machine shop, and that is because when this go-kart was built, they milled out these keyway slots in the exact locations where they needed all the components. We're going to be moving all this stuff around, so we're going to be milling a slot the whole way through it, and that'll just open up the freedom for me to put all this stuff wherever I want it. So the machine shop isn't going to be able to mill this thing with all this stuff still on it, so all of this has to be taken off. So as you can see, the go-kart axle is all cleaned up. All the components are finally off of it. That was a pain. These bearings, they were either pressed on or rusted in place. I'm not sure which one, but it took a hammer and this board and a lot of whacking to get those off. And I also had to kind of sand off some of that rust. So I got some connections. That machine shop already got me this axle back. And you can see that keyway slot is milled the entire way through. Looks gorgeous. So the next thing we got to do is rip apart these little skid plates, whatever you want to call them, the little guards for both the rotor and the drive sprocket. And then we'll also pull this seat off and the gas tank. And if you're anything like me, you always seem to be working on these projects when there's a full tank of gas. That's just how it is. back of this thing is all cleared up now. Got the seat out. All of our fuel lines are out. This brake cable's freed up. That fuel tank's out of here. Now we're able to move on to the pedals. And I also got to remove this skid plate. The pedals and the steering assembly look like they're connected in here. So all that will be coming out. They actually fastened this skid plate using rivets. So every single one of these guys is gonna have to be drilled out. Got these pedals all freed up, and the problem I was running into is they had a tack weld right in here, and this pedal assembly, there's a rod that goes through here, these little pins, and those slide along this channel, but with that tack weld, I wasn't able to get it the whole way forward. But once I sanded down that tack weld, you're able to get it forward, up, and it slides out of that notch. The pedal assembly is out. I'm gonna get this fuel pump out, and then I think there's four bolts holding this engine on, and we'll get this thing pulled. All right, all the big components are out. We got the pedals out, the engines out, the fuel lines are out, the caliper's out, and the fuel pump is out. The cart is looking pretty empty, and I was gonna remove all these steering components, but there was a bracket on the front here, and that apparently broke off at one point, so they just welded this whole assembly on, which means I can't just unbolt it, so I'm gonna have to cut that out. So that'll be on the next video. So this is what this Ford Mustang is going to look like one day. All the hard stuff is done. Everything that was bolted on that frame is pretty much taken off of it. Now comes the fabricating part where we have to start cutting this frame down to be able to stuff it into this body. If you guys are excited to see how this thing turns out, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button.